Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is GamerLCD, and it's been quite a long time since I've made a Diablo 3 video, and I know a lot of you guys are subscribed to my channel for this game, so I thought it would be really, really nice of me to give you guys an update on what's going on with me, this game, and what you guys can expect from me in the future with this game. So, while I do that, you guys will be seeing some Diablo 3 Torment 6, hopefully, gameplay in the background. And so Diablo 3, I got really into it when Reaper of Souls came out. I've been a fan of Diablo 3 since it first came out, and I wasn't a huge Diablo 2 player, and I didn't even play Diablo 1. I believe it really was Diablo 3 that got me really into this game series, and I've liked it ever since. But I went hardcore into Diablo 3 when it first came out, the vanilla version or the classic version. And then I also got really heavily into it when Reaper of Souls came out. The huge problem with Diablo 3 when it first came out was the lack of content, right? You just basically, even if for a Diablo gamer, the sole purpose of it is just to grind gear the entire time. Like, there really was nothing to do in this game. Even if you had maxed out your gear, which is something that was really easy to do in classic Diablo 3, there was just really no reason to keep farming. I mean, like, you need a reason to farm better gear, like, and that didn't exist in the vanilla of Diablo 3. But ever since Reaper of Souls came out, they've been slowly adding in a lot of good in-game content, like, you know, greater rifts and stuff like that. And I'm doing a rift right now on Torment 6 with my Crusader, and again, I haven't played this game in literally months. Like, so when Reaper of Souls first came out, I played it, like, hardcore for, like, 2 months, and then I slowed down a bit, I didn't play it for a few months, and I came back to it. And I went hardcore into it again when Greater Rifts came out, and then I played it for a month, and I stopped playing it again. And now, this video on December 9th is the first time I've been playing it in quite a while. And I love this game. I think it's really fun, especially leveling up new classes if you've never played the other classes before. It's really fun to go ahead and level up those new classes. As far as seasons go, a lot of people like playing seasons where you start with a brand new character every single time, but I never was interested in that. The seasons in Diablo 3 are terrible in my opinion. There's nowhere near the same thing as ladders in Diablo 2. Seasons in this game are quite useless and quite dumb in my opinion. Sure, there's leaderboards, you know, whoever gets level 70 first, yada yada yada, but aside from that, there's really no competition. Like, people are always finding, you know, cheap ways to abuse the quest system and do the easiest bounties and stuff like that to get a level 70, and it's just a waste of time. Like, and the worst part about it is that they made it so that when you play seasons and you get these season only legendaries, the legendaries carry over to your regular tunes at the end of the season anyway, so there's really no incentive to play the seasons. I mean, like, when the season is over with, you can just find the same exact legendaries that all the season players got access to. It's just that the seasonal players get access to them a little early, and I just find that kind of pointless. Like, there's no real incentive to participate in seasons, except for, you know, the achievements and stuff like that, which really don't mean anything in this game, because they don't offer any real rewards. You know, rewards in, like take World of Warcraft, for example. Like, those achievements in World of Warcraft actually reward you with stuff. But an achievement in Diablo 3 doesn't really reward you with anything except for the occasional banner reward. And banners are kind of stupid. Like, they dumbed down banners a lot from when they first previewed them at BlizzCon all those years ago. Like, banners were supposed to be something very cool that you could upgrade and, you know, find different stuff for. And the pedestal would be, you know, awesome looking depending on what difficulty you beat the game on. And they never did anything with banners, so it's kind of stupid. Greater rifts. So greater rifts, I'm kind of good with greater rifts. They're some sort of content, but at the end of the day, they're not like the end all be all content for me personally. I know a lot of people have a lot of fun with greater rifts. It's supposed to be like this really competitive in game feature, but for me, it's not really that competitive, right? I'm not going to be someone who plays this game, you know, 7 or 8 hours a day to compete for greater rifts. It's just not going to happen. So I don't really see that as content for me personally, because, like, especially if I don't do greater rifts, then I'm just, you know, a bad player at this point, right? So I haven't played this game in months and months and months, so I'm really behind on leveling up my legendary gems, and there's really no catch-up mechanic, so it's just kind of like, you know, I'm a weak character right now because I don't participate in greater rifts. Now, patch 2.1 is coming up. Patch 2.1.2, it's on the PTR currently for Diablo. And they demoed this patch that's coming up. I believe it was at BlizzCon is where they talked about this patch a few weeks ago. And it's going to be introducing not a whole lot of new content, but definitely some cool things that are going to make this game a little bit more interesting. First of all, they're adding in a bunch of new legendary gems. Those really aren't going to apply to me all that much, like I said, because legendary gems are kind of useless to players who don't like to participate in greater rifts. I mean, doing a greater rift occasionally with our friends or, you know, every once in a while is great, but, you know, doing it as a casual and, like, a non-pre-made group is really, really hard. So there's more legendary gems. You got new gem variants. I think they're adding in a new gem type, I believe. I could be wrong on that, but I haven't looked up too much of it, but that's what I've heard. They're also adding in new goblins. So new goblins are going to do different things. So there's always been two types of goblins in this game, and they always did the same thing. There were treasure goblins and goblin bandit, or bandit goblins. And they usually just drop the same thing. Either one drop gems or one drop, you know, loot. But in the new patch, they're going to be like three different new, or it's either three or four different versions of the goblins. There's going to be a red goblin, a blue goblin, and like an ice goblin. And they're all going to drop different stuff. One could drop legendary gems. One could drop various loots. One could drop, you know, it's just different stuff like that. One could drop blood shards. I believe that's one of the examples they gave, was that the red one drops blood shards. These things right here. Blood shards are kind of useless right now, in my opinion. Like they up the cost of blood shards, so that it costs more blood shards to buy things with them. And I don't agree with that. It feels really less rewarding, in my opinion. Like it costs 50 blood shards for one amulet or one ring. That's ridiculous. And the cap on blood shards isn't going up either, so it's kind of weird. Obviously, the patch is going to contain some balance changes. They made a tweak to Act 1 so that the professions or the artisans are a little closer, so you don't have to run all the way to the end of the map to get to the artisans in Act 1, which is a quality of life change thing that I noticed there. There's some new legendary items coming to classes. I believe Wizard and Barbarian were the two highlighted ones that are getting like brand new class sets. And in my opinion, they added a new class set to the Crusader in this last patch. Which was useless, by the way. The Roland set is pretty bad. Like, the Archon set is literally the best set in the game for any class right now. It is so well designed. And the Roland set that they tried to come out with, the melee set for Crusaders, is just not very good at all. I tried the sweep build, I tried the shield bash build, and it just pales into comparison to anything you can do with the Archon set. So I'm kind of frustrated about that. Like, Crusaders need a really good set. I'm trying to build a, what do you call that ability? I'm trying to build a stampede set. I don't even remember what the skill is called. The one where you can just spam the archer. I have the shield for it, but I'm trying to farm the ring so I can get, like, the infinite archers. I don't remember what it is. But anyways, I want to know what you guys think. Are you guys still playing Diablo 3? I know a lot of you guys stop and play this game, and then, you know, you keep playing it, and then you stop, and then you keep playing it, and then you stop over and over and over again. What's that ability called? Phalanx. That's what it's called. The Phalanx ability, where you can just spam the archers, and then they do a crap ton of damage. I believe the ring allows you to have, like, two of them at the same time, and the shield reduces the cost or the duration, or increases the duration or something like that. I don't remember, but I've been farming for this for a while. But I just stopped playing because, you know, it's really hard. So yeah, I'm really looking, I guess the whole end of speech for me is, I'm really looking for some content in this game that wants me to keep playing. Like, the Greater Rift system is not a system for casuals. It's just not. Like, especially if you don't play like a lot of the hardcore players do every single day, and you're Paragon like 1000 or Paragon 800 or 900, it's a very limiting system for casual players, because if you don't keep up with it, you're gonna fall way behind on legendary gems, you're gonna fall behind on the loot that drops from the end bosses and stuff like that. So definitely I'm looking for a system in Diablo 3 that I can just log in and it'll take me 2 or 3 minutes to complete, and that's it. That's what I'm looking for in Diablo 3, and I don't see much of that. And I think that's one of the huge problems, that it still lacks content for the casual player. Like, seasonal thing, like, no casual player is going to play seasons. They just don't have time for it. They can't devote all this time to a seasonal character, which isn't even a real character. It gets deleted at the end of the season, and basically all that time is wasted. They have no progression on their real character. you know, greater rifts, like I said, it's really hard to keep up with for a casual player. I'm looking for that system, and this probably is going to be PvP, and, like, PvP is something that I've been waiting for in this game for a long time now, and they showed it off at E3 in 2008 and 2009 when they first revealed this game, and it's still not in the game yet for some reason. They just don't see it as something that is important, but it is very important to the game. They want to get it right, they say, but how long does it take to get it right? They should be focusing on PvP full-time now. Like, there's really no excuse to keep developing all this content for Diablo 3 and skipping over PvP just because you don't want to take the time to figure out how to do it correctly, you know? And I've never been a fan of PvP in MMOs or RPGs or anything like that. I'm a PvE type of guy, but the fact of the matter is that I need something in Diablo 3 that I can just log in and, you know, I can play for 5 minutes. I like doing rifts and stuff like that. It just takes too long. I don't have that type of time to put into this game, especially when I'm a full-time YouTuber. I'm a full-time streamer. I just don't have the time to put into, like, you know, these characters when it comes to these in-game systems like seasons or greater rifts. I need something that allows me to just, you know, log in for 5 or 10 minutes and that's it, you know? So I really do hope that PvP comes to this game soon, because, like, if they do it like a Team Slayer or an arena type of PvP in this game, then I can just log in, you know, do like an arena match or do a team death match real quick and just log off, right? That's what I want for Diablo 3. And I don't know what you guys think about that, but the updates that they've been doing so far, they're just not appealing to me. Like, Greater Rifts were fine for like a week or two when I was playing this game, but at the end of the day, like, I can't commit that much time to Greater Rifts and all these hardcore in-game systems. There's no casual system for Diablo 3 right now aside from rifts. And rifts get really repetitive, like extremely repetitive. And so do bounties. Like, I need something that's not repetitive. PvP is going to be that something. Like a real PvP, not this brawling system that no one ever uses in this game. I need some constructed, organized PvP that I can just log in, you know, queue up for some team deathmatch or queue up for some free-for-all or something like that and just go to town on PvP. That's what PvP needs to be in Diablo 3. It just needs to be something casual that you log in, sign, you know, queue up for a free-for-all or a team deathmatch and just have a little bit of fun for a few minutes. And that's what I'm really looking for Diablo 3. I think that's all I wanted to talk about in this video, guys. I just wanted to let you know where I'm at with this game, why I haven't been putting out some content lately. And hopefully you guys can let me know what you think about Diablo 3, where you're at in this game, and what you think about my feelings are about this game. I love this game. I hope there's going to be some content in the future, specifically for me, someone who just doesn't have, you know, 6 hours a day to put in this game, because that's really how the hardcore players play this game. They play it, like, you know, for at least 4 to 5 hours a day. And I need some casual content. And I went over all the reasons why in this video. So, my name's LCD, everyone. Thank you so much for listening and watching. Hit the like button if you guys enjoyed this video. Perhaps consider a subscription to my channel, and I appreciate it. Check out my live streams at twitch.tv/gamerlcd, and I'll see you next time. Have a great day, everyone.